Just jotted down the first covenant of David. She was not about to falter or fall by the way. She knew Jesus can. You didn't hear that, Jesus? Did you hear that? I'm sure he did, but this woman didn't hear a word that Jesus said, because the most surprising part of her day is that he did not answer her a word. Silent treatment, quiet, almost rude rejection. What's going on? Looking again at those three letters at the top of my notes and wondering, could Jesus just have been having a bad day? Or was he being C-A-N-T-A-N-K-E-R-O-U-S? Jesus cantankerous? The woman never thought life would go this way when she came in the presence of the Son of David. She had much bigger expectations, maybe because she had heard someone tell her about the good news of healing and hope Jesus can bring. Maybe she had heard Jesus preach the same word you have heard: hope for the hopeless, help for the helpless, freedom for the possessed. Was Jesus maybe just so spellbound, pardon the pun, that this woman would approach him, that he was just at a loss for words? Was he just tired from all the moments of ministry and hoping to dodge another troubling request, hoping she'd just go away and maybe catch up with him another time when he came through town? Or was this his way prompting her to say more? Whatever the reason, even his disciples chimed in and they said, it's better that she get along and not cause further embarrassment. And it's then that some might think Jesus adds insult to injury when he says, I wasn't sent to anyone but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. That might have been the last straw. Might have been enough to make this woman give up. But she was even more persistent, worshiping him and saying, Lord, help me. Kneeling before the Lord, she thought, he can't say no to me. With every ounce of persistence, in great desperation and with great boldness and hope, Lord, help me. Again, she is rebuffed by a cantankerous Jesus in what appears to be his harshest terms yet. It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs. A totally unfair and sensitive, offensive slur on Jesus' part, acquainting a woman with a C-A-N-I-N-E. Now, this Canaanite woman was her most articulate yet, the comeback she had. Yes, Lord, still addressing him as Lord, but even a Canaanite eats the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Even with all her troubles and concerns about her daughter, do you sense this woman had a wit coupled with her determination to give Jesus a reason to heal her daughter? She does not debate or dispute her status that is way, way back behind the Israelites. Instead, she humbly acknowledges she's of Israel, she's a Canaanite. This woman does not deny the children of Israel have a primary spot at the table. She recognizes herself as having no worth, no value, no claim to Jesus. That's her reality, and no less our reality. It's as if she admits, and we can admit the same, yes, Jesus, I deserve your rejection. I am lowest of the low. I am miserable and wretched and unworthy. Why should I presume to come to your table? The gospel today is going to the dogs. Great is your faith. Be it done to you as you desire. For a Canaanite, faith even accepts crumbs as enough, because even a crumb fulfills God's promises. So we receive the mercy, hope, and healing. Is it a crumb? Is it more? It doesn't matter. Faith doesn't measure the gift, but receives what God gives with open hands and with a thankful heart. Faith believes that even a crumb from the Master's table is good and will fill our bodily as well as spiritual needs. Gifts of the world come and go, and not less. But what the world considers worthless, the Lord's forgiveness and life and salvation will ever satisfy and never end. Haven't you heard His word and promise? I baptize you. I forgive you. I have died. I am risen. I will come again. Words of promise, words of life, cling to them. And like the Canaanite woman, we will not be disappointed. Have mercy on me, O Lord, Son of David. Spoke with all boldness and confidence in her deepest, most desperate need. O woman, great is your faith. Mercy is what we receive when we don't deserve it. We, and St. Paul says it better than anyone else in Ephesians 2, we who were once separated, alienated from the commonwealth of Israel, strangers to the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world, but now brought near through the blood of the cross, members of the household of God, if even for a crumb. Have mercy on me, O God, is our period. As to a Canaanite, even to you and me, with our falling short, with our broken spirits and unclean lips and cries of desperation, Jesus can. Now the peace of God